In this special build edition of the AI Show, we will hear from Vijay Kannan, Senior Program Manager on the Azure Machine Learning team. You know what? Your machine learning's only as good as your data. Vijay will show you how to increase your productivity with data labeling using Azure Machine Learning. Make sure you tune in.
Good morning. Thank you for joining this session. My name is Vijay Kannan. I'm a program manager in Azure Machine Learning. In this session, we will be focusing on data labeling in Azure ML and how ML-assisted labeling can help in the labeling process. Talking about data labeling, this is an important step before you can train an ML model for computer images. You have images, you need to specify the expected output, whether you are looking to classify the images or you are looking for objects in images. Next, we will talk about why it is challenging to do data labeling. First, it is about data. If you have a huge amount of data, you want to avoid moving the data around and still make it available to do the labeling. Second, you need a multi-user labeling tool that will allow multiple people to work in parallel to do data labeling. Third, the workflow. You need to distribute the task among many people so that they can work in parallel on different data points. Also, keep in mind the data labeling can be iterative. Depending on the volume of the data and the number of people involved in labeling can become a project management problem where you need to optimize on cost, time, and quality. Quality control is extremely important because poor quality label means poor models. Finally, you want to do your data labeling without compromising on fundamentals, that is privacy and security. Many of you might be working on sensitive projects or solutions. Azure ML data labeling integrates very well with datasets. It consumes a dataset and after labeling, it produces a dataset. You get all the benefits that comes with the dataset. It comes with a pre-built browser-based multi-user labeling tool, so you don't have to write or maintain your own tool. On the workflow front, it takes care of task distribution and also allows you to iterate on your labeling projects, which is a very powerful feature. It has various capabilities for project management, and of course, it is built on top of Azure privacy and security. The labelers who are going to do the labeling are authenticated using AAD or MSA. Here is our demo flow. We will use a data set based on images that is kept in blob store. Then we will create a labeling project as a data scientist. We will label few images ourselves. Then we will sign back into the project management portal and check the quality of the labels. And finally, we will export the labels as a data set. Next, we get into the very interesting portion, which is the demo of the AML data labeling tool. What you see here is the Azure Machine Learning Studio. In Azure Machine Learning Studio, we have various assets like notebooks, AutoML, data sets, experiments, pipelines, compute, data store, and etc. Towards the bottom, we have the data labeling capability. Once you click on the data labeling capability, it will load the projects list page as you see on the screen. In order to create a new data labeling project, you should click on Add Project button, which is on the top left. Creation of the project include 4 to 5 steps. First, you need to provide the project name. Next, you need to choose the project type. Today, we support 3 project types: image classification with multi-class, image classification with multi-label, and object detection. You need to choose the project from the drop-down. For this demo, I have chosen the project type as object identification bounding box. Now I click Next. The next step is selecting or creating a data set. I have already created a data set pointing to my Azure Blob Storage, which I am going to use it in this demo. At this point, even you can create a new data set altogether. Now I click on Next. The next step is about defining the labels. Now I will go ahead and create the labels. Now I click on Next. This is the labeling instruction page. In this step, the project manager or the data scientist can draft a set of instruction or guidelines for his labeling team, which would help during their labeling process. Now I have typed in the instructions here. Now I will go ahead and click Next. The last step is the ML-assisted labeling. In this step, the project manager can seek the help of the machine to do the automated pre-labeling. The ML-assist process will kick in after receiving certain number of manually labeled images. In order to turn it on, we need to enable this checkbox, enable ML-assisted labeling. Then we need to provide a compute. Already I have created a GPU compute for this project, which I am going to use it. If you don't have the compute at this point, you can still go ahead and click Create Compute. After providing the compute, you just need to click Create Project. The project creation process takes few minutes. Now we have created our project. I will go ahead and click on the project. Once the project page is loaded, it shows the default dashboard page. This page shows the progress of the project. We have not labeled any images so far, so the progress is shown as zero. Now I will go ahead and click on the data tab. The data tab has two subtabs, dataset preview and labeled data. Dataset preview tab shows some sample images from the source dataset. Now I will go ahead and click on the details tab. The detail tab has various subtabs. The first is the project details. By clicking on the project details, we will be able to see what is the project name, what is the project type, when it was created, and who created it. Clicking on the input dataset, we'll be able to see what is the dataset name and what is the data stored. Then we have the intermediate label storage tab. When we create a new Azure Machine Learning workspace, internally a workspace gets created. We will leverage this workspace when we export the labeled dataset. By clicking on the Label Classes tab, we will be able to see what are all the various classes which we defined during the project creation. During the execution of the project, we will also be able to add new labels. Again, the instruction also can be updated during the execution of the project. Also, ML assist processing can also be turned on or off during the execution of the project. Now we have configured the project, let's get into the most interesting portion, which is labeling data. I'm going to go ahead and click on the label data button on the top, which is going to display the labeling experience. When the labeling experience loads up, it shows the instruction page. In this case, I as a project manager or a data scientist of this project, I myself can label the data. So I will go ahead and click Start Labeling. In order to do manual data labeling, first I need to identify the object which is of interest to me. In this case, it is cars. First, I need to go ahead and click on car as my label. Now I will go ahead and draw a rectangular bounding box for the gray car. Here, I see a red car overlapping with the existing car. In order to draw a bounding box within a bounding box, it is easier to lock the existing bounding box. In order to do it, first we need to go ahead and click the lock function, which will lock the existing bounding box. Now I am good to create a new bounding box for the red car. After creating the bounding box for the red car, I will go ahead and click on unlock. Now I have a bounding box within an existing bounding box. If things looks good, I will go ahead and click Submit for my next image. In this picture, my object of interest is the person. So I will go ahead and click the label as a person and then draw a rectangular bounding box for this person. Here I have the option to zoom into this image or even zoom out. I will be able to adjust the brightness of the image as well by adjusting the slider control. Also, I'll be able to adjust the contrast of this image as well. At times, we might get an image which does not fit into any of this label category. To handle it, we have the skip function as well. If you want to skip this image, we are still can go ahead and click skip. Here everything looks good. I will go ahead and click submit. In this case, the object of interest is the boat. So I will go ahead and click on boat and then I draw a bounding box. If everything looks good, I will go ahead and click submit. Now we have three images labeled. Let's log back into the project and see what is the progress on the project. By logging back into the project, in the dashboard page, you will see the progress of the labeled data set. At this point, as a project manager, if you want to review the work of your team of labelers, you can click on data and then click the labeled data set tab. Here, you can review the labels of the labeled data outputs. At this time, if you are unhappy with any of the labels on a specific image, you can still go ahead and reject that image. What this will do is, it will put back this image back into the labeler queue for relabeling. At any point during the execution of the project, you can go ahead and export the data. Today, we support two ways to export it. One is export as COCO file. The other option is export as Azure ML dataset. I will go ahead and export as Azure ML dataset. It will take a minute or two to have the dataset created. Now we have successfully exported the labeled output as a dataset. The labeled output dataset is available in the dataset tab. Here you would notice the exported output. Now let's get back to the ML assisted labeling presentation. Now let's talk about ML assisted data labeling. This is a feature we have released in public preview for image classification. And for object detection, it is in limited preview mode. Please contact us if you want to use this capability. Now let's talk about ML assisted labeling data flow. At high level, this is how it works. You have label data. There is a task creator component that create tasks for human labelers. Human labelers pick the task and start labeling, so you can get the label data. This thing continues, and of course, you are free to export the labels if you want. However, we do something more interesting once we have certain number of label data available. We train a machine learning model in the background and use the output of the model in various ways. Initially, you can expect the quality of the model will not be good, but still it is usable. You can use the output of the model to cluster the data points together. At this point, we start giving cluster tasks to labeler and they start seeing very similar images coming together. The idea here is to reduce the cognitive load or context switching for them to do a better and a faster labeling job. As the model quality exceeds the confidence threshold, it will start producing the pre-labels for each image, which would help the labeler to perform labeling at a faster pace. Now, let's look at the demo for ML-assisted data labeling. I have created three projects for this ML-assist demo. One for bounding box, the another one for multi-label, and the third one for multi-class. All these three projects have reached the pre-labeling state. Let's go into the bounding box project and see how the machine has generated the pre-labeling bounding boxes. I will go ahead and click bounding box. I click label data. Start labeling. As the first image loads up, I see already the bounding boxes have been marked by the machine. I'm very happy how the bounding box shows up here. So I go ahead and click submit. For my next image. Here, already the machine has marked the bounding boxes for various objects like bus, car. I'm happy with this as well. So I click go ahead and click submit. Now let's look up how pre-labeling shows up for the multi-label project. So here is the multi-label project. I will go ahead and click. Here, the machine has already marked the pre-labels. As a labeler, I don't need to do anything if everything looks good. So I'm happy with how the pre-labeling is done here. So I will go ahead and click Submit. Again, on the next image, the machine has already marked the pre-labels. I feel things look accurate. I'll go ahead and click Submit. Now, let us look at the example for multi-class. Label data. Now, already the machine has marked the pre-label for this image. So this is identified as a subway. I am happy with the pre-label. I will go ahead and click Submit. Even the next image is marked as a subway, which is correct. So things looks good. I will go ahead and click Submit. This is the demo for ML Assist. Here are the session resources. Feel free to try out our product and ML Assisted labeling. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us. Thank you.